I'm still here. Am I gonna be alone? I thought I was gonna be here.
And we also have the cast. James McAvoy.
I read the novel, I don't know, 4 years ago. I'd never read anything like it. I didn't know about the depths of the ocean, but didn't know much about Somalia, except what everybody knows. And I thought it was the most amazing story, and Cameron, the producer, figured I should do this. And I thought he was right. I thought this was a territory where I had not been, and it was dark, but there was also something else in it. And I remember Martin Luther suggesting to fight darkness not with darkness but with light, so I thought maybe with a little guidance I can handle this story. And that's what we did.
And for the cast, what was it that compelled you about the script and this project?
I promise I'm not a pirate. I liked this story because my manager submitted me for the role, and then Uncle didn't find me, so my tape.
He calls me Uncle then.
He saw my tape and he offered me the role. Accepted. It's the character that I played, Amir Yusuf, is very sophisticated guy. I mean, we're talking about a guy who was, thank you. We're talking about a guy who was behind the bombing of 1998 in Nairobi, US Embassy in Nairobi, Tanzania. Amir Yusuf has been trained in Yemen, Pakistan, Afghanistan. He used to work with Osama bin Laden. And this guy is a very, very sophisticated guy. And when I saw the character, I was like, will I be able to bring this guy into real life? And it was very tough. And with the help of the writer, Erin, who's not here tonight, and you know, with the support of the director and James, I think I bring it up.
And Hakim knew a lot about this story. He knew about the territory, and he was incredibly helpful. He spoke the language. You lived your first 9 years there, or 10?
In Mogadishu, yes. I grew up in Mogadishu. I was born in a small village right next to 60 kilometers outside of Mogadishu, and I grew up in Mogadishu. So I've seen a lot of war, and I've experienced it. And there's a lot of things I cannot talk about right now, but you know, I lived through that war. Mm.
So. And Hakim was there whenever we shot with these soldiers and these people, and he was knowledgeable not only for accent but also for wardrobe and habits and how they behaved and how they spoke. So he was became my main man. Except of course with this man.
Mom. Cal, please.
Oh well, you get an email saying Wim Wenders film, you just say yes. You know, I would have come and peeled the potatoes on the boats. You know, I would have done anything. I was in. You had me at hello when we started. And
does that make you Renee Zellweger to his time?
I think I've got the figure.
Next time
I'll peel the potatoes. Yeah, we and that was it. Yeah, and then you say you're gonna have a Skype with Wim Wenders and you think, okay. It's like sort of online dating. We worked out we both urinated on the same monument in the UK, and I was in. But we've just seen the film for the first time. It's a bloody good film.
Yeah.
away the tears. I'm really moved. Brilliant. You're the maestro. And James, you are phenomenal in this movie. It's beautiful to be part of a story that is so encompassing. It's probably a beautiful story about the human spirit and the fact that it's the last thing to break. It's about the darkness and the light and the idea of love will endure throughout the hardest of times. And I think it's about that we're all on the same planet. I think it's a really important piece. So it was a pleasure to come and peel the potatoes. I think I look fetching in my yellow jumpsuit.
This is a very unique character. A very unique character to play. What was it that compelled you about this role?
The thing that compelled me to take the role was the opportunity to do something very specific, which was portray a couple or one half of a couple that fall in love, but they are two very similar people in that they intensely intelligent, articulate, philosophical and scientific in their bones. And so that their love and their courtship is likewise intelligent, articulate, philosophical, poetic and scientific. And I thought that was a bit unusual for film and something that I thought was a challenging and tricky prospect, but something that I was really excited about exploring. And two people who were resigned to the idea that they might die to do what they loved. And yet they find each other and all they want to do is live. And I thought that was fascinating.
Mm. Questions from the audience? Yes, in the blue. The question was, how did the torture scenes challenge you mentally and physically?
I need to put this cup down because I'm going to just like drop it. It was, you know, I just walk off.
Really?
Like, I've had enough. I've done one other film like this where I got victimised and tortured and bullied and all those things, and it got to me a hell of a lot, and I knew that coming to this film, there would come a time after all the romance friends, that I would get all that again, and I thought, I'm probably going to feel like a bag of shit. And I did. It took 3 days of being in Spain, filming the interiors of all the stuff that happens in Africa, and it made me feel like a bag of shit. So, but you know, it's that cliche thing that actors say, you just use it, you don't try and make it not make you feel like shit, you just soak that up. And for about 4 weeks in Spain, and about, I don't know, 3 weeks in Djibouti, something like that. It just felt pretty nasty, really. And you wait till the weekend, and then you go crazy, and I did go crazy to try and sort of alleviate the nastiness. It was just nasty. But that was the story, and that was it. Don't get me wrong, it's not like we were being all method acting. Nobody was beating me up in between takes. Nobody was withholding food from me. But it wasn't pleasant. But it's part of it, isn't it? It's the story that I wanted to tell, and it's the story I was passionate about telling.
More questions for the audience? Yes, in the back corner, yeah. Questions for all of the actors about their process and how they made the choices they did.
Okay. My character, Amir Yusuf, I did a lot of research, especially when I read the book, and also I had to call a lot of officials in Somali government who dealt with personally with these people, like the government who captured all the jihadist groups and Al-Shabaab or all those groups, and I called them and I asked them, like, especially this character, Amir Yusuf, like, the way, you know, his lifestyle, how he acts, how they talk, you know, we're talking about a guy who's been trained in so many different places, who speaks in different many languages, and I had to do a lot of research on him, especially, you know, how he walks, how he talks, what kind of food he eats, and he has a couple of kids at the beginning, first scene. I don't know if he's in, he has a son that he wants to be trained. And, you know, I did as much as I could. I don't know if that answers your question.
I love the idea of being like a big brother character, you know, to play a character that just sort of loved Danny in a different way that that the other characters do, that sort of cares for her survival, her professional survival, and her. So I just love that idea that there is a guy that, you know, just cares about her well-being. So I love that brother and sister relationship. And then we went to the Atlantique in the Ephemera, and we did some studying and had a go on the submarine and learned that up until the late 70s, fact folks, nobody believed life existed below 500 meters. Mm. That was it, yeah. Like everybody said, below 500 meters, nothing, just darkness. And now they go to 6,000 meters and find these little shrinky things in the hydrothermal vents. I think shrinky things is the technical term. yeah, A plus in the science. And then you just sort of give yourself over to the actors. You've got brilliant actors to work with. It's reacting, and then also you've got them sets the sort of stage where you're able to play, so you're not so conscious of presenting something that you're just available for the story and each other. So the process of sort of giving, you know, Alicia is so great. You know, she just lives it, breathes it. There's no sort of line learning for this here. I mean, she says we run lines, and then sort of 5 minutes into it, the tears are coming, and she's involved.